We'll stick around for this one. Valentine's Day, it is just 1 week away. But instead of getting that same old, you know, box of chocolate, the flowers, let's get creative. There are creative ways to say I love you. And here to give us a few ideas is Director of Design at Bold Catering and Design, Brian Worley. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you. How are you?
Such a treat having you. These look so fun. You know, the old things that just get so boring. So how do we step it up?
Well, I just think that you're throwing a it's Valentine's Day. You want to be creative with your gifts because I think that the standard thing of box of chocolate is so like passe. I came up with a few ideas that I wanted to show you right now. This is what I call a fortune cookie balloon. It's kind of taking the fortune cookie, but then you can write any of these, you know, write down a note, I love you, something, your sweet nothing. So if you want to do that, I'll open up the balloon.
I love that. Okay, this is really revealing what my nickname to Jim is. Sorry.
Pootie. I love Pootie.
I love Pootie. It's a, listen, don't make me, it's silly, but he's my little poo. And, you know, this is just, I'll make sure I take this balloon home. Make sure it lasts for the week. Okay, this is so adorable.
So you just do that. Fill it up with helium.
Got it.
And all these have, you know, notes. It could be like, pick another fortune balloon. Here, you
want
to, I'll hold it.
Woo, okay. This is so exciting. You do it for the kids, too.
What does it say?
It says, it's never too late for good things to happen. I love that.
There you go.
Okay, cute, clever, creative. And again, if you do have the kids, I say get the kids involved.
Yeah, you could, I mean, and you could do it. You could do it for a proposal. Don't propose on Valentine's Day, super cheesy.
Yes, yeah, Brian says absolutely no. Right. By the way, before we get to the second one, tell me a little bit about how you got into this business.
So I just recently moved here from Los Angeles five months ago. So I'm adapting to the Atlanta lifestyle, which is very different than California. Working for a restaurant group too, I've really enjoyed fried chicken.
Yes.
So the fried chicken tacos at El Taco, I think I've had them like every week.
Well, good.
And so I'm
the benefits of being in the South, right?
Exactly. Fried chicken. I never ate this much fried chicken in my
entire
life.
Right. What about sweet tea? That too.
Well, sweet tea. Mm-hmm. I'm not a big caffeine drinker, but I have had my share of sweet tea.
Okay,
as well.
But definitely the fried chicken, the biscuits.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. Well, welcome to town.
Well, thank you. Thank you for having me.
These are beautiful too.
Okay,
wow.
So these we did. I think that roses are so again like a box of chocolate. So kind of you can dress it up with some other flowers. Ranunculus, escabiosas, just a beautiful flower arrangement that lasts a little bit longer.
Be creative, and I'm with you. I like roses, but I like some of the
other.
You
gotta mix it up.
You gotta mix it up.
Doing a bouquet of roses with some baby's breath and fern is like 1980s, so let's bring it into
2018. All right.
Okay, so this was another idea. I think it's kind of like a memory box or a memory bag, actually. So I literally just took a very inexpensive bag that someone had given me.
Right.
Recycled,
reused. I have a ton of them. Right?
Yeah, you have one, so I just cut out a few hearts.
Cute.
You can have the kids help you with this one, too. So then I just filled it with kind of like, this is actually a flask, but it's a heart, so.
That is adorable.
You can have that.
Okay. Love this.
So this is kind of like a trip down memory lane. This is a journal log.
Idea log, yeah. I love that.
I'm going
back to paper in the new year, and so is my husband. We like to forget the eye calendars. Writing it down and crossing it off, such a good feeling.
I like to just know that I have something tangible there.
Yes, so I'm with you.
Write your notes, write your memories. It's kind of
so
like a diary.
Cute. Okay.
So you and I, we love movies.
Yes.
So here's some popcorn and movie tickets.
Oh my gosh.
It's kind of things that you can do together, things that, a creative way. I mean, this wasn't very expensive.
No.
I got it for like $2 and just dressed it up.
Brian, that's adorable.
Like if you want to go really.
Cartier watch?
Exactly.
Oh.
So, I mean, like you could do like.
Cute.
Right? Jewelry.
Guys, if you're watching, what a great idea.
Don't do an engagement ring on Valentine's Day. Super cheesy.
That's according to
a book, The Giving Tree. It's like, this is our relationship. This is our love together.
Right.
So
that is fabulous.
We love wine. So it's a wine cooler. I would also wrap all these things so that it's always more fun to like wrap, think Christmas, but Valentine's Day.
Right.
So another thing.
I like that you said you're going down memory lane and kind of things that are just important to you and your relationship and maybe the way that it even started.
Well, and so I think that I love stationery.
Yeah.
It goes back to paper. And I always give people stationery with their name on it and then stamps because you always forget the stamps. So
that
I think that
so
if you
true.
Provide the stamps, it's a much better extension.
And they will write more notes.
Exactly. If they have the stamp and they don't have to go to the post office.
I love that.
And then this one, if you're really in love, this would be like, there's a plane ticket to Hawaii in here and a pineapple luggage tag.
Luggage tag.
So it's kind of like, this is, it's taking us into the future. It's showing us the past. It's you know, it's a trip down memory lane in a bag.
In a bag. And just the fact that you were being so creative, really thinking through the gifts, to me, that would win me over every day. Jim, if you're watching.
So, okay. Pootie.
Yes, thank you. I'll explain that online.
Okay. So, I think you can also recreate your first date. So say your first date was at South City Kitchen or Lure or something like that, then you could recreate that and then you bring all of your family and your, not your family, but your relationship person, your significant other, and you kind of recreate it at home, or you can make a reservation. Mm-hmm. So we have some wine, because I mean, who doesn't love wine on Valentine's Day?
A little bit of
Amarone
here, blush, and then rosé.
When you open your gift bag, then you can stick the wine bottle, especially rosé.
Yeah, now let me ask you, are you somebody, do you prefer to go out on Valentine's Day if you have a significant another, or are you one of those people who likes to just keep it simple at home?
I think keeping it simple at home. I think that it's one of those, it's kind of like New Year's, it's so overrated.
Totally agree.
That, you know, it's like you're going to end up sometimes spending more money sometimes if you go out. But if you do go out, like pick a restaurant that, you know, a lot of them have specials nowadays too. So, I mean, you can definitely look into that avenue. But I think that there's something special about like having that time with your significant other, really enjoying the day, enjoying the night. And then if you have like, these aren't not expensive things that I just showed you.
Right.
I mean, the helium tank, some balloons, and just some thoughtful words, like those go a long way. And I'm kind of sentimental, so I like something that.
These are so good, inspiring us all. Cheers to you.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day, Brian. Thank you so much. For more of these great ideas and tips, visit bold-events.com. I like the name of that.
You like that?
Events.
It's bold.
I like it.
It's bold and stands out there.
Yes, it is.
We
okay,
do good work.
Cheers.